this question. This is 1 kg, 2 kg, 3 kg, 4 kg, 5 kg. Okay? And they are placed on the sides of an imaginary square. Okay? The side length of the square is 1 unit. You need to find out the center of mass of this entire system. System has 5 particles. First thing what you should do? First thing is, place your xy coordinate, then only you will know what is the x and y coordinate of the particles. Okay, your x and y coordinate could be different depending on what coordinate axis you take. Can you tell me the zone where the center of mass should be? Center of mass should be here, 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 where it should be? Somewhere between 4 and 5, because most amount of mass is around that. So let me take a coordinate axis. This is y axis, this is x axis. What is the coordinate for 4? This is 1, 0. This is 1, 1. That is, and this 0.5, 0.5. Simple. So x center of mass, how do you find that? 1 into 0 plus 2 into 1 plus 3 into 1 plus 4 into 0 plus 5 into 0.5 divided by 15, sum of all the masses. And similarly YCM, YCM will be what? 1 into 1, 2 into 1 plus 3 into 0, 4 into 0, 5 into 0.5 divided by 15. Isn't it simple calculation? Yes or no? Okay. Now, can the coordinates of center of mass will be different for different axis you take? If I change the coordinate axis, will the coordinates of center of mass change? Coordinates will change, but the location won't change. They're two different things. Location will remain this only, but if your coordinate are this, it will be related to this coordinate. But if you take coordinate axis which passes through this point, originally this point center of mass will become 0, 0. So coordinates depends on what coordinate axis you take, but the location, the relative location will be fixed. Any doubts in finding the center of mass? Okay. Now tell me what is the assumption we have made when we have considered a system of particles like this? No, it is at rest, correct, but then I can say that they are moving, but right now this is the location. So, need not be. There are particles placed at different locations. We have not made assumption that they are rigid body. It could be 5 different particles placed at different location. The assumption is that they are all particles, point masses. Are you getting it? What if the 5 kg mass is a big circle like this, which is not located exactly at 0.5, 0.5. It is spread across in an area. Then you can't say mass of 5 into 0.5, because 0.5 is not the location of the entire object, right? We have assumed that while applying this formula, we have assumed that all the masses are point masses. What if they are not? Then how the formula will get modified? Let's talk about that. It should come out. Write down x will be equal to. Now suppose your system has two masses One is point mass of mass M2, and this is a bigger mass of mass M1. Okay, then I will say that this M1 mass is made up of multiple point masses. I will divide this M1 into different point masses starting from small m1 to small mn. They are the small masses that are making the bigger mass. Okay, because the formula I have is for the point mass, I can't apply directly to the bigger mass. So I've assumed that bigger mass is made up of small point masses. Getting it? So if that is the case, then x will be equal to the small point mass inside m1 into location of this small m1. Let's say location of that is x1. If I divide it into small point masses, then I can find out the point masses location. Right? So m1 x1 plus m2 x2 and so on up to mn xn. This will give me summation of mi xi for the entire capital M1. Getting it? And summation of all the small masses will be equal to capital M1 or not? Okay? This plus the second mass is a point mass. M2, let us say capital X2. This divided by total mass of this M1 plus total mass M2. Getting it? Now see what I am doing. I am multiplying divide by M1 in the numerator. So M1 X1, M2 X2 and so on divided by M1 plus M2 plus M2 X2 divided by M1 plus M2. Now tell me, what is the first term in the numerator? This is what? This is the center of mass of the M1. Yes or no? Right? So the formula gets modified to this. M1 into center of mass of M1's location plus M2 into X2 divided by M1 plus M2. This will be total center of mass. So if there is a bigger mass, you multiply the entire mass with its center of mass and location. Got it? Write out. If there are multiple bigger masses, then M1 into its center of mass plus M2 into its center of mass and so on divided by the total mass of the system. Okay? No doubts, right? Okay, let us. What? Okay. It's a simple formula. M1 into its center of mass plus M2 into its center of mass, so on and so forth, divided by total mass of the system. Okay. Now write down few points about the location of center of mass. Points to be noted. If mass is uniformly distributed, okay, if mass is uniformly distributed, then the center of mass location of center of mass is location of centroid. Okay, location of the centroid. How it comes? You can see that x is equal to m1 x1 divided by m1 plus m2 and so on. If mass is uniformly distributed, all the point masses will be of the same mass. isn't it? All the point masses will be of the same mass. So x coordinate will come out to be x1 plus x2 and so on divided by total number of particles, n. And this is the coordinate of the center, coordinate of the centroid only. Okay? So naturally it comes out to be like that. If mass is uniformly distributed. Okay? And hence, please write down, if there exists a line of symmetry with respect to the distribution of mass, then the center of mass will lie on the line of symmetry. If you see a line of symmetry, center of mass will be on that line only. Getting it? Okay. What if there are two lines of symmetry? Can two lines of symmetry be parallel? Not possible. Okay. So if there are two lines of symmetry, two lines of symmetry are there, then the intersection is center of mass, because it should lie on both. Got it? Now there are few regular shape objects for which you don't need to break your head where is the center of mass. For example, this television, where the center of mass will be if mass is uniformly distributed? You draw diagonals, that and that. Line of symmetry is there, right? Diagonal. Intersection of the two diagonals, or intersection of this line and that line. Okay? Very simple. So, just tell me, where will be the center of mass for this? Suppose this is made up of steel, the half of it, and half of it is made up of wood. Where the center of mass will be? Is there a line of symmetry? Is this a line of symmetry? Is this? So center of mass will be somewhere here, and it will be somewhere on this side. Getting it? So do not look at the geometrical shape to find out line of symmetry. You should look at the distribution of mass. Okay? Alright? The center of mass of the ring will be where? Center. Center of mass of sphere, center. Okay. Cylinder along the axis at the center. And rod, the center of the rod. So like that. It's a common sensical thing. Okay. For a cube, intersection of diagonals. Okay. Rhombus, again intersection of diagonals. Parallelogram, again. Okay. Please write down, center of mass for a continuous distribution of mass. Suppose I have to find out the center of mass of some object which is not regular shape and size. Okay? Then I can't apply the formula summation of m1 x1 because there will be infinite particles and also there will not be any line of symmetry to help me out. Okay? Then how to find the center of mass location? The summation will get transformed into integral time. Okay? And this is how it will happen. So x center of mass is summation of mi xi divided by summation of mi. Okay. Now I'm saying that suppose there's a big mass, okay, irregular shape object here up. This big mass is there, irregular shape and size. I'll assume that the entire big object is made up of small masses of mass dm. Dm is the small mass and its location is x. The location of dm is x. So the numerator will become what? Integral of x dm divided by integral of dm. Summation will get transformed into integral. Integration is what? Summation only. Any doubts? Okay. Now can you integrate this just like that? What is the problem? Why I cannot integrate this? So, first of all, I don't know the limits. Upper limit, lower limit, I don't know. Second, there are two variables, x and dm. Okay? So how do I get to know these two things, limit and x as a function of m or m as a function of x? For a particular situation only. For a given scenario, I'll get to know what is the limit for that scenario, and for that scenario, what is the relation between m and x. But right now, this is the formula. It is like force is equal to mass and acceleration. You can't solve it because you don't know what kind of forces are being applied. Okay? Similarly here, this is a formula which you have to solve for different objects. Any doubts? No.